Welcome to Christmas Eve Jazz Vespers 2021. I'm Lynn Carman Bodden, the interim pastor here at the First Reformed Church in Schenectady, and I welcome you to this time of celebrating and reflecting. Maybe you'll do a little dancing at home as we focus both on the fun of the season and the reason for the season. So we invite you to sit back, to have a snack, maybe a beverage, and to join us. We have Max Caplan on piano tonight, and Mike Lawrence on the bass, and Nathan Schied on the drums, and we are going to have a special guest reader later on this evening. But we invite you to join us in worship tonight. The first piece the band is going to play is Angels from the Realms of Glory. To share with you first tonight a reading called The Plastic Angel by devotional writer Anne Weems. Our crush set came complete with stable and a plastic angel. Small, not at all to scale, the white garbed creature with uncertain wings was obviously an afterthought, thrown in to complete the set. Otherwise, ceramic and hand-painted. Unless, of course, this angel was a last-minute substitute for one which was irresistible to the packer. In that case, somewhere I have an irresistible ceramic angel dressed gloriously in red, kneeling or flying on somebody else's coffee table even now as I unwrap the plastic angel. If I could ever bring myself to throw away an angel, it would be this one. This one with no redeeming features. And yet, each year as I unwrap the plastic angel, I hesitate again to pitch this celestial messenger. I'm reminded of my own lack of glory, my own plastic attempts at celebrating Christmas, my own feeble annunciations, and once again I place this bit of plastic over the stable. If the plastic angel can get this far, perhaps there's a place in Bethlehem town for me. The next piece is, O come, Emmanuel. The next piece we'll hear after I read is, While Shepherds Watched Their Flocks. And we are all watching and waiting tonight. So hear this blessing from the community of Iona in Scotland. God of the watching ones, the waiting ones, the slow and suffering ones, the angels in heaven, the child in the womb, give us your benediction, that your good word for our souls, that we might rest and rise in the kindness of your company. Amen. Up our special reader. Come on. We welcome up tonight Cecilia Lawrence, who's going to share with you a little reading from Leonard Cohen, and that's going to then be followed by three pieces the band will do, and I'll let them introduce those pieces.
Ring the bells that still can ring. Forget your perfect offering. There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in.
So our next pieces, we have three pieces. Brazilian sleigh bells to go with the bell reading. Sing We Now of Christmas, and a part of Vivaldi's Winter. The Adagio.
Thank you.
Christmas Eve brings interesting things and interesting beings and interesting music together. That was a Brazilian samba, a familiar old British carol, Sing We Now of Christmas, and a jazz take on a Baroque piece by Vivaldi. And so it is. Another reading from the Wild Goose Worship Group from the Iona community in Scotland. This tonight is the meeting place of heaven and earth. For this tonight is the stable in which God keeps God's appointment to meet humanity. Not many are high here, not many holy, not many innocent children, not many worldly wise. Not all familiar faces, not all frequent visitors. But if tonight only strangers met, that would be enough. For Bethlehem was not the hub of the universe, nor was the stable a platform for famous folk. In an out-of-the-way place which folk never thought to visit, there God kept and keeps a holy promise. There God sends the Son. O little town of Bethlehem, and then O Christmas tree.
Thank you.
We are going to move from a little town to trees. We've moved through trees, and we are about to move to animals. We like to talk about the animals at Christmas and who was in the stable, etc. And I want to share with you tonight a story that is related in a book called Christmas Comes Alive, written by a pastor named Geneva Butts. Geneva Butts, in the late 1980s and 90s, was a pastor of the old Reformed Church in Philadelphia, which is located at the corner of 4th and Rose. That is not a Reformed Church like the First Reformed Church here in Schenectady. This is a Dutch Reformed Church. The Reformed Church in Philadelphia is an old German Reformed Church. This church is near to Independence Mall, and for many, many years, I don't know if they still do it, but they had a live creche scene in downtown Philadelphia with animals for quite a long time. Sheep and cows and donkey and what have you that would come, and homeless people and business people and people who worked at the Federal Mint and things like that would all come by to see what was happening. And this is a story of something that happened one year with the sheep. I returned from a trip to Princeton, less than a 2-hour drive north of Philadelphia. The animals had arrived that morning, but I had thought it safe to make a trip out of town for a few hours. It was almost dusk when I pulled into the church driveway and headed for my office. Ed met me at the creche and excitedly reported the news. The sheep are missing. They've been gone about an hour. We've looked everywhere for them. See, there's a hole in the back of the stable. He rushed me to the rear of the creche, and sure enough, there was a hole just wide enough for sheep to squeeze through. Lois has been out looking in all the back alleys of the old city, Ed continued. Just then Lois arrived. No sheep anywhere, she sighed. Together we searched behind the church building one more time, thinking they just had to be hiding there. What to do now? I'm sure the sheep aren't covered by our insurance policy, I thought. How could this have happened? Did someone steal the sheep? Or did they run away of their own accord? How will I face the farmer? What kind of pastor am I anyway to let my sheep get loose? How will I ever find them? I recalled my first Christmas Eve at Old First. As the shepherds entered the tableau, I announced their arrival with the familiar words from Luke's gospel. Suddenly, a sheep appeared at the front of the stable. One at a time, the other two sheep came out to the people. All three had heard my voice and responded right on time. But now, three sheep were missing. They had wandered off while I was out of town. Well, what does an urban pastor do when she loses her sheep? Yes, I did. I phoned the police. Sure, lady, said a voice on the other end of the telephone. You lost your sheep. And I guess your name is Bo Peep, too, right? No, I pleaded. I really did lose three sheep. I'm the pastor of the church at 4th and Ray Streets, which has the live animal Christmas creche. The animals arrived this morning, and now three sheep are missing. There's a big hole in the back of the stable, too. Okay, we'll send a car right away, the officer said as he hung up. A police car appeared in a few minutes. The officer was courteous and listened patiently to our story. We showed him the hole in the rear of the stable, and then he asked me to sit in the police car so I could help him write a report. He wanted a description of the animals. Funny, he muttered, that no one called in. You'd think anyone seeing sheep wandering freely through the city would call the cops. I'll check again to see if anyone's made a report. No one had reported seeing our missing sheep. Okay, he said, I'll put it on the radio and we'll get an all points bulletin out right away. Meanwhile, I'll drive through the back streets of the old city to see if I can find them. I'll be in touch. I went back to the crush again. Where are my sheep? I cried. There was nothing to do but go inside the church office and wait. I thought I should telephone the church trustees to let them know what had happened. Also, I'd better get our carpenters back to repair the hole. Before I realized it, the donkeys and maybe even the cow will break out. I was sitting at my desk talking to one of the trustees when all of a sudden, the lights went on in the creche. Night had fallen, and the automatic timer had triggered the lights. Out frolicked the three sheep, quite innocently. I could barely believe my eyes. They were back. The sheep had returned. I ran out to the creche crying, "The sheep are found! The lost sheep have come home!" There was no one there to hear me, but I just had to shout it. Well, guess what? The sheep had never wandered away. They had been in the back of the stable all along, lying down among the folds of Mary's robe. They must have battered the hole in the stable wall, but they had never run away. It had been dusk, and no one had seen them hiding there in the straw. Could this be the case with church members who we think have left our institutional church, I wondered? The back door may be open, but many of our lost members haven't gone out. Can we see them? Are we looking in the right place? They're still hiding in the membership rolls, and especially at Christmas, they nestle very close to Mary. The next piece the guys want to play is "Do You Hear What I Hear?" which begins, I believe, with the little lamb. So that song goes from the wind to the lamb to the shepherd boy to the mighty king to the people. Let's hear the story told in reverse, as it is recorded in the Gospel of Luke, beginning with in the second chapter with the first verse. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. We'll now hear Mary's boy child. Thank you. The story continues in the Gospel of Luke in this way. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth, peace among those whom God favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Silent night. Thank you. We have one more piece of music to share with you tonight and one more short reading, but before I read that, I'd like to thank all of you again for joining us this Christmas Eve. And we hope that the gift you have received from this music and these readings has touched your heart and drawn you into the spirit of this Christmas season. We thank you for the gifts that you have to offer to support Jazz Vespers whenever you can. I want to thank Max Caplan again on the piano and Mike Lawrence on the bass and Nathan Schied on drums. I want to give a special thanks to Dave Pizzolo, who is doing the video and making this possible for you to see it tonight. And a special thanks also to our special guest, Cecilia Lawrence, who is fading at the end of this night. I'm Lynn Carman Bodden, and again, we thank you. I leave you with these words of Howard Thurman. It is the brooding presence of the Eternal Spirit making crooked paths straight, rough places smooth, tired hearts refreshed, dead hopes stirred with the newness of life. It is the promise of tomorrow at the close of every day, the movement of life in defiance of death, and the assurance that love is sturdier than hate, that right is more confident than wrong, that good is more permanent than evil. I will light the candle of fellowship this Christmas. I know that the experiences of unity in human relations are more compelling than the concepts, the fears, the prejudices which divide. Despite the tendency to feel my race superior, my nation the greatest nation, my faith the true faith, I must beat down the boundaries of my exclusiveness until my sense of separateness is completely enveloped in a sense of fellowship. There must be free and easy access by all to all the rich resources accumulated by groups and individuals in years of living and experiencing. I will light the candle of fellowship this Christmas, a candle that must burn all the year long. Amen. You'll recognize this one.